Demons are generally depicted as supernatural and malevolent beings. They have appeared throughout the centuries, having some sort of presence in folklore, myths, and literature of many different cultures, seeping into all forms of media in our modern times. That includes comic books. Some of the most terrifying threats to our favorite beloved heroes comes in the form of a demonic being. Now, most superheroes have come across a demon in the past, and many demons make up a very important part of various publishers' multiverses. So today we are taking a look at one publisher in particular and counting down the top 10 scary demons in Marvel, because they got quite a few. Now be sure to stick around till the end of the video with us and share with us your thoughts on what other demons you think should have made our list. Alright, let's get to it. And at number 10, Surtur. Sure, yeah, he's likely more powerful than some of the other demons who will land on the higher spots on our list, but this is about ranking scary, my friends, and we all saw this demon in Thor Ragnarok, and yeah, he was powerful, but he was not scary. He made me giggle. That aside though, let's take a look at Surtur from the comics. First appearing in Journey into Mystery issue 97 in 1963, this demon isn't just a mystical baddie with the power of a thousand blazing suns, which yes, that is pretty horrific in itself. He's also over 1,000 feet tall, he's a fire giant from an extra dimensional plane that's known as the Land of Fire Demons, and his power is of apocalyptic proportions. Aside from manipulating fire and generating intense heat, Surtur also has the ability to manipulate on a molecular level, transforming his fingers into serpents, as seen in Journey into Mystery issue 99. He also derives from Norse mythology, prominently being a figure during Ragnarok, in which the flames he brings forth engulf the earth. So yeah, no thank you. Would rather not die in a fiery hell. In at number 9, Mephisto. Like Surtur, Mephisto is arguably one of the more powerful demons kicking around the Marvel Universe, and if this were a top 10 powerful demons list, he would definitely find himself in the top half. But in terms of being scary, while Mephisto does fit the bill, he suffers from two factors. The first is that out of all of the demons on our list, he is the most human looking. Second, we've been desensitized to the character, with him being one of the most commonly appearing demons in Marvel's panels. Sure, he wields terrifying power, but unlike some of his other nefarious peers, he is much less mysterious to us. Mephisto first appeared in the Silver Surfer issue 3 in 1968, a foe for Galactus's Herald and the Cosmic Hero, and a tempter who, according to Mike Conroy, I quote, could offer the endlessly soul-tormented Silver Surfer the world. Now, this immortal demon has been a perennial antagonist in the Marvel Universe since, capturing and hiding souls, posing as Satan, and generally just being and similar to our previous number, Mephisto also derives from another fictional historical figure. Mephistopheles, a demon hailing from Faust legend in German folklore, and is a devil who makes deals with Faust for the price of the mortal soul. And at number 8, Calumet. Calumet is a lesser known demon compared to the others on our list, yet he is still a terrifying creature. Just look at him. Worshipped by the cult of Calumet for centuries, he is a demon who looks like a humanoid goat. He first appeared in Dead of Night issue 11 in 1975, which was also the debut of his biggest foe, Scarecrow. Not to be confused with DC's Scarecrow, that is. He also goes by the name Strawman. Strawman is the reason why Calumet only has one horn. He ripped it from the monster's head and then sealed the dimensional gateway between the two realms behind an oil painting, trapping Calumet. Unlike the other demons on our list, the full extent of Calumet's power is still pretty unknown. But he is the lord of an extra-dimensional realm and had enough power to take over the Earth, although those powers were severely limited on our planet since he couldn't fully access it. You know, the whole dimensional rift thing. Portals, yay. That being said, he could use his abilities to grant power to others and send demons to Earth on occasion. So who knows what he could have done if he had had his full range of powers at his disposal during his comic appearances. We don't even fully know if Calumet is still kicking out there. Strawman would later inform Doctor Strange that he succeeded in destroying the demon, but there is nothing but Strawman's own word to confirm whether or not the demon is actually gone. So who knows, maybe he might pop up again in the future. And at number 7, Nightmare. Nightmare is like Marvel's Freddy Krueger, but minus the camp and knives for fingers. Nightmare is the ruler of a dream dimension, and is a fear lord. In this dream dimension, he torments humans who have found themselves there while they sleep. He is pretty whack. Nightmare imprisons humans in his dimension and even tormented Doctor Strange when Doctor Strange forgot to recite a spell before he went to bed. And if that wasn't scary enough, Nightmare rides around in his dream dimension on a demonic black horned horse, who was named Dreamstalker. How beautiful. He has the ability to draw power from the psychic energies of the subconscious minds of dreaming beings. And he has nigh omnipotence, omniscience, omnipresence. So all in all, Nightmare is not a demon you want to screw with. Moving on to number 6, Dweller in Darkness. Dweller in Darkness first appeared in Doctor Strange issue 30 in 1978, although had been mentioned in Marvel lore a handful of years earlier in Thor issue 229 in 1974. Now this immortal demon is capable of some fear-inducing abilities. Actually, Dweller can generate fear in other living beings, which in turn empowers and sustains him. In addition to that, he can create sentient creatures out of fear, he can turn deceased humans into shadow thralls, and he does not age. But here's where it gets really creepy. The Dweller became the demon he is thanks to the Way of the Shamblu, a ritual that involved the Dweller removing his own head from his body. His body died, but his head lives on as a corporeal being. It uses a robotic body, in case you were wondering. In at number 5, Zarathos. If you are a fan of Ghost Rider, Zarathos is a name that will be more than familiar to you. Zarathos first appeared in Marvel Spotlight issue 5 in 1972. In a 1973 Ghost Rider comic, the immortal demon was given a more embellished backstory, in which the physical stone body of Zarathos had long laid underground until a Native American tribal sorcerer summoned him in order to help his tribe. Now, if Zarathos helped them, the demon would be given a steady supply of souls to consume. He was down. The more souls he consumes, the more powerful he becomes. Now, because of this relationship, a cult forms following the demon, which then catches the attention of our man Mephisto. Mephisto's all like, dude, no one should get more attention than me, and gets into a brawl with the demon, who then loses and ends up having to serve Mephisto. Zarathos is forced to spend his time in the netherworld, which is kind of like hell, with the exception of being bonded to humans in order to ravage souls, so he can go up on Earth. Here's where Ghost Rider comes in. Now, Zarathos' strength and power is typically likened to Mephisto's, with the latter being just a little bit stronger than he is. He can control the elements on Earth and likes to trap his opponents by having the ground itself engulf them. He also likes to create rock spikes in order to impale people. What a fun guy. Moving on to number 4, Set. Set is the first elder god of Earth on our list today. He is an incredibly powerful ethereal being with vast cosmic powers. Set may have been spawned over 4 billion years ago, but he was first mentioned in Marvel's comics in 1971, in Conan the Barbarian issue 7, and then fully appeared in 1976's Marvel Future Volume 2 issue 6. Was that right? Yes, it was. He is limited only by his inability to leave the pocket dimension in which he resides. Sorcerers are able to call upon him for power, though, and individuals wearing the Serpent Crown can also be endowed with some of his power, which ranges from levitation to mind control. Except be wary. Set would often taint the minds of those who are under his influence, controlling their minds to an extent. But here is where things get wacky. Way back when, Set discovered that if he ate his brethren gods, his own power would increase. So he became the first ever murderer. But because of this, he began to degenerate into a demon. And he started a trend with other elder gods committing the same act and also becoming demons themselves. More on that later though. Moving on to number 3, we have Dormammu. Dormammu is one of the first demons that come to mind when you think of demonic individuals lurking around the Marvel Universe. Created by Stan Lee and Steve Ditko in 1964, his first appearance was in Strange Tales issue 126. Now, Dormammu is often considered to be one of Doctor Strange's most prominent foes, or as Strange calls it, his most terrible foe. He is also one of the universe's most powerful mystical entities. Why is that? Well, it's because he is composed of mystical energy that can be used to achieve pretty much anything. We are talking matter manipulation, energy projection, teleportation, possession, necromancy, resizing, bestowing a power, or creating other demons. That's a lot of scary. He's empowered by the worship of his followers, and while he's strongest in his home of the Dark Dimension, there have been times in the past where he's neared an almost multiversal scale of influence. Yeah, that is pretty terrifying. Imagine if he was real. I would be pooping myself with fear. Up next in our number 2 spot, Shuma-Gorath. Shuma-Gorath is known as the Lord of Chaos. Ooh, fun. First appearing in Marvel Premiere issue 5 in 1972, this demon's name was taken from a short story by Robert E. Howard, titled The Curse of the Golden Skull, that featured a dying magician who used the ironbound books of Shuma-Gorath to curse humanity. As such, this demon in the Marvel Universe is a curse to humanity. Having ruled over the world, it demanded human sacrifice before it was eventually banished by a time traveler. More recently, in the 2013 Infinity story arc, we saw Ebony Maw of the Black Order manipulate Doctor Strange to summon Shuma-Gorath to New York City, of course, which, as you can imagine, did not go over well. So what's so horrific about this demon, minus its aesthetic? Well, it is an ancient force of chaos, nigh invisible, and is a godlike ruler of over 100 different alternate universes. It can imitate the magic of others, it can alter reality, shapeshift, teleport, project energy, and much, much more. And worst of all, it can automatically destroy multiple galaxies via aura pressure alone. What the f***? As stated in Strange Tales Volume 2, Issue 14. Yikes. And finally, at number 1, Chiton. Chiton is another elder god with vast cosmic abilities. And by vast, well, we mean he might arguably be the strongest, most powerful demon in the Marvel multiverse. Similar to Set, he degenerated into a demon the more that he killed, with his desire for power being absolutely ceaseless. He is responsible for creating many a demon, and is often depicted as the ultimate primal evil in the universe. Chiton, who gives us major Cthulhu vibes, first appeared in Marvel Chillers Issue 1 in 1975, where he was simply called The Other. He wouldn't get a name until Avengers Issue 186 in 1979. Devoted to the study and manipulation of mystical energies, Chiton would become Earth's first master of black magic, and even experimented on his fellow gods. The only one to really oppose him, and to protect us, is Gaia, the Earth goddess and one of the only elder gods who did not fall into corruption to gain power. But having immense foresight, knowing Gaia would bring about an end to his freedom, he had written all of his spells and worked down on indestructible parchment, which would eventually become the Darkhold, the Earth's first tome of black magic, and a gateway for Chiton to eventually return. After being defeated and exiled, he resides in his own dimension, spawning a race of demons capable of returning to Earth, even though he himself couldn't. Now these days he tends to possess characters in the Marvel Universe, from Scarlet Witch to Quicksilver, with Wanda actually having to endure that twice. Luckily Doctor Strange helped her out and freed her from the demon's influence that last time that had happened during Secret Empire. Fun stuff. Alright, there we have it, friends. What other demons in the Marvel Universe do you think are scary? Are there scarier demons in the DC Universe or another publisher's world that you can think of? Give us a shout in those comments below and let us know your thoughts and feels. If you guys dug this video, you know the drill. Spread that love, hit that thumbs up button, and be sure to subscribe to Top 10 Nerd if you haven't already. We'd love it if you stuck around with us some more. In the meantime, thanks for watching, friends. I'll catch you all in the next video.